Hello, everybody. This is Guido Pickert from Aixtron. I'd like to present our Q3 9-month results that we recently published and run you through some highlights of those. First of all, one of the major drivers is really the high order momentum that we see. We see the order momentum continuing from the past quarters where we were able to report order intake levels of above 100 million compared to previous levels in the double-digit range. This is very, very encouraging. And we reported an order intake of 114 million in Q3. And we believe, or we see no reason why this should be lower going forward or below 100 million going forward over the next quarters, as at least what we can see. Reason for that is we still have high inquiry levels from customers from all different areas of applications that we are serving. Therefore, this is, as I said, very encouraging. The Q3 orders were largely driven by demand from the areas of gallium nitride power electronics or optical and wireless data communication, as well as by LED applications. The revenues that we reported were as scheduled above the Q2 levels. We are anticipating revenues and shipments to be again above the Q3 levels that we had. In Q3, we reported around about 131 million of revenues. Those almost doubled quarter on quarter. So you see that the trend is going in the right direction. As I said, Q4 revenues will be higher again than that. In the 9-month period, we had revenues of around about 248 million versus 161 a year before. And the gross margin in Q3 was 43% versus 41% the quarter before. And on the 9-month period, we reported 41% gross margin versus 39% year on year. Our OPEX in the 9-month period was 60 million compared to 53 year on year, the year before. We had two special effects that were influencing this OPEX position. One was a restructuring charge of our OLED daughter, Apiva, of 3 million. And a year ago, we had a special effect from operating income, where we generated 3 million from a revaluation. Yeah? Apart from that, we had higher variable compensation as elements influencing the OPEX figure, as well as higher R&D, mainly for the area of MOCVD, which is our core technology. 9 months EBIT almost tripled year on year. This is a very, very good example of our leverage that we have, or strong leverage that we have on higher revenues. It almost tripled year on year to 17% EBIT margin. And in Q3, it was even more pronounced. We had a 28% EBIT margin, which was a long time high that we recorded there. And you can imagine in Q4, we still have some potential to always also be high. Nevertheless, we believe in Q4 we will have more lower margin products that we ship, and therefore this effect might be slightly diluted. Nevertheless, all these financial figures are encouraging, and we are confident to reach the orders within our guidance at the higher end of that. And we are confident to reach the revenues required for our guidance and also the gross margins and the EBIT margins. To give you a quick update on the corona situation, we have that very much under control at Aixtron. We have few cases only. We have our supply chain in very close contact and very close to us, and had only minor effects going forward. The supply chain as such, as we know, is tense, but we believe we have everything under control as we are heavily outsourced. So let's see where we end up at the end of the year concerning our revenues, how many tools will actually leave the factory by 31st of December. We'll let you know. Well, after confirming our 2021 guidance, I can give you at least a qualitative outlook to 2022. We will definitely start the year 2022 with a strong order backlog, meaning that that will translate in strong H1 revenues. And given that we do not see a weakening of the inquiry levels by our customers, we could see also orders feeding into that for the next year's revenues, and therefore we believe the overall year will be a strong one again. Where we will end up and where we believe the revenues and other values will be, this we will tell you when we come out with our full year figures on February 24. And until that, we will have to keep it qualitative. The areas of demand in 2022 that we will see driving that direction are, again, similar to what we've seen this year. It is gallium nitride power for energy efficient charging, for energy efficient power supply. It is also silicon carbide power for the upcoming usage in electric vehicles and infrastructure applications. It is partially LEDs or micro LED contributing, but it is also, again, to a large part, lasers for data communication, for example. We all are waiting for the glass fiber networks to be built out to our home, fiber to the home. This will only be possible with lasers made on our tools. So we see that our customers are investing into that to make this possible. And lasers for 3D sensing are currently limited to a lower demand, but that might come back to a certain degree. We don't see that in the very short term. So it is mainly 5G and the fast data availability, the higher data volumes driving fast data communication. And this is what we see to remain the strongest part of optoelectronics. With that, I would like to conclude our quick run through our Q3 and 9 months results and the outlook to 2022 as far as I could give you some. I'm looking forward to talk to you again at the time when we come out with our full year results and take a joint look at 2022. Thank you very much, and look at Aixtron as the enabler of compound semiconductors.
Hi there, since you watched this company video until the end, I'm guessing you liked the video. And that's probably because we work very hard to create the most engaging and added value content for you. If you're a company and want to find out how we, at Seat 11A, can make a company video with and about you, please email us at content@seat11a.com.